16 villages in Metro Manila remain under granular lockdowns, even as the region shifts to the least stringent alert level. Interior Secretary Eduardo Anio says nationwide, 21 local government units, or 104 villages, are under granular lockdowns or localized community quarantines.
Sa ating pong patuloy na pagbaba ng kaso, ay patuloy naman po ang pag-implement natin ng granular lockdown. Kahit po sa alert level 1, ang mga LGUs ay magsasagawa pa rin ng granular lockdown para sigurado na matichat pa rin po natin kung sakaling magkaroon ng transmission sa isang lugar. So bahay, karsada, block, o barangay ay pwede pong ilagay sa granular lockdown.
Metro Manila and other areas shifted to COVID Alert Level 1 today. Vaccine Chief Carlito Galvez Jr. says the country was able to overcome the highly contagious Omicron variant, allowing the capital region and other places to return to a new normal. But he still urges Filipinos to remain vigilant.
Finally, nakaraos na rin po tayo sa ating mahigpit na pagsubok sa nadala ng Omicron. NCR together with 38 areas will begin the roadmap to the new normal exactly 1 year after we started the vaccination program. However, kailangan pa rin po natin na maging vigilant at gabayan natin ang buong sambayanan, ang ating LGUs at lahat ng institusyon to self-regulate and manage and live with the virus.
Under Alert Level 1, establishments can operate at full capacity. The health department even says moviegoers can now eat inside cinemas again. Eating and drinking were initially banned inside enclosed theaters as they pose high risk of virus transmission.
Pinayaga na po ang pagkain sa loob ng sinihan dito po sa ating pong barangay po. Ayun pong ating establishments, meron silang additional protocols para sundin nila para po tayo ay mas protektado. So essentially, pag sinabi natin, parang pre-pandemic pero bagong normal para sa atin lahat.
The Philippine Health Department says it will no longer release daily COVID case bulletins. Starting next Monday, March 7th, the bulletin will only be published once a week. It will also be revised by focusing on severe and critical cases, as well as the ICU utilization rate in the country. But the agency clarifies the case tracker on its website will still be updated every day.
Kung kailangan niyo po ng mga datos galing po sa ating response for the pandemic, meron pa rin po tayo. Yun lang pong case bulletin, we are going to change, no? How people perceive and how people look at how the situation, no, in this pandemic. Gusto natin mas bigyang tuon ng mga tao yung pinaka-importanting aspeto nitong COVID-19, because we are going to live with the virus already.
Business groups welcome the de-escalation of the COVID alert level in Metro Manila as a great first step towards returning to pre-pandemic times. But at least one expert believes the move is not enough to revive a pandemic-hit economy. Juan Indy Guzman reports.
The Management Association of the Philippines says Alert Level 1 is a great step toward returning to pre-pandemic production and operations. But it says some businesses may likely opt for a hybrid model of operations, wherein some employees will continue working from home, having discovered the cost savings and quality of life gains that go with it. For Presidential Advisor for Entrepreneurship Joey Concepcion, the decision to lower the alert level in Metro Manila is a good one, as it will help small businesses deal with the storm of rising commodity prices created by the Ukraine conflict. He adds, it will assist the Philippine government in paying off its own debts, which have grown to 60.5% of GDP due to pandemic-related spending and poor tax revenue collections. But former Philippine Central Bank Deputy Governor Diwa Ginigundo says the easing of alert level is not enough. He stresses several other steps are needed, including the supply of funds to MSMEs, which he says received the brunt of the damage from the pandemic-induced recession. Ginigundo adds, the Philippine government needs to prove to the public, including its creditors, that borrowed money had not been lost to corruption.
Let's make sure that public money is spent on things that are necessary to ensure that the pandemic is managed and managed well, and at the same time ensure that economic recovery is underway. Restoring public trust is very important. And that is the major agenda item of the new government.
There have been allegations of misused funds against the Duterte administration. Regardless of how those allegations are resolved, the debts incurred to pay for pandemic expenses are real, and the Philippines can ill afford to default on those payments. The last time that happened was in 1983 during the Marcos dictatorship, when the Philippines was also facing rising interest rates and spiking oil prices while holding large amounts of debt.
We should roll out a plan so that the market will know that the government, number one, recognizes the importance of the problem. Number two, that there is a corresponding timetable for reducing the debt to GDP ratio. We cannot do it in 1 year or even 2 years. It's a process. If you take a look at the estimate of NEDA on the damage brought about by the pandemic, it costs trillions of pesos for the next 10 to 40 years.
Warren De Guzman, ABS-CBN News.
The National Economic and Development Authority, or NEDA, is optimistic the economy can finally start recovering its losses due to the pandemic as Metro Manila and dozens of other areas shift to Alert Level 1. NEDA Secretary Carl Chua says the move will benefit 62% of the economy and 48% of workers. He adds the move will also add some 9.4 billion pesos per week of economic activity.
As the economy bounces back, we now have to recover all the losses we experienced in the last 2 years. Yung total amount na nawala sa atin ay 3.8 trillion pesos. If not for the pandemic, dapat tuloy-tuloy yung ating growth. Nakikita naman natin yung dahan-dahan na pagtaas ng ating ekonomiya. Pero yung gap between before COVID and with COVID ay malaki. Dahil sa pagsipat po ng Alert Level 1 ay mas mapapabilis yung pagbawi natin.
Trade Secretary Ramon Lopez meanwhile adds the shift to Alert Level 1 may generate up to 500,000 additional jobs. He adds the work-from-home arrangement is still allowed but no longer encouraged under the least stringent alert level.